I'm going to introduce you to Dr. Jay Grossman, who has started an organization called Homeless Not Toothless. And you're basically administering to homeless people. That to me is a bit anathema to how we feel about homeless people who are out there by choice. People think, we know that's not true, but they're out there, but they need dental hygiene as well, don't they?
They most certainly do. And of course, without teeth, what are they going to do? Are they going to get work? Are they going to get a job? Of course not. So even if they chose to get back into society, it would be very difficult because they would be very limited with what options they would have.
We had a dentist that would come out and treat these homeless kids, and it's just so lovely. They would come out and help all these kids who were living in shelters, but I'd never seen, ever, a dentist who would bring homeless patients into their office and help them. And when I went into Dr. J's office and he was treating patients in his office, I was pretty blown away.
Lacking the self-confidence after being out there for 15 years, just, you know, running amok, I really had lost a lot of my drive. And that's the incredible part about the story, is not only did Dr. J provide me with my dental needs and put a set of teeth in my mouth here, but he stood by me as a friend and as support in keeping my sobriety.
John has been working and living at Dr. J's home for over a year. He is just one of around 2,000 homeless people helped by Dr. J since the beginning of the Homeless Not Toothless program in 1992.
He's been an endless support and rock for me. A true pillar for me to maintain my sobriety, and he's my best friend. I love him to death.
We have several medical hubs throughout our county that provide medical expertise to our children. They are staffed with medical experts. However, we are lacking good dental care. This is when we rely on people such as Dr. Jay Grossman, the CEO of Homeless Not Toothless, because we need expert dental care in all of our facilities to be able to combine that with the expert medical care so that our children get comprehensive medical and dental care to provide them the outcomes they need to overcome the foster care system.
In the past, the MAC facility had some challenges. It was the residential facility for these children. And they were sneaking out at night. They were climbing over the walls, literally. They were going out into the El Monte community. They were coming back using drugs, pregnant. They were averaging 50 deaths a year because of drug and alcohol-related instances. So now, the opportunity exists to give it a whole new name, a whole new face, to actually show the El Monte community what we can do. And what we're up to causing right now is building a medical and dental facility where we could take care of the 28,000 children in foster care and give them the needed medical and dental care they need, not just for their own health, but so they could be allowed into school. You realize that without that stamp that says medically and dentally that they've been approved, that they can't even go to school. I can't even imagine what it would be like that they don't have families, they're living in somebody else's house, they don't have the medical care they need, the dental care, and now they're not allowed into school. So we're raising private funds and an endowment that allow these children to be taken care of forever. And that's what's available here at the MAC facility.
It's the way you look. And for a lot of children in foster care, that's all you have. The kind of ridicule and, you know, the embarrassment, the teasing for a kid is a big deal. If it wasn't for Homeless Not Toothless, there would be a lot of children in foster care having to deal with that kind of shame and embarrassment on their own. Homeless Not Toothless will make a difference in these children's lives.
I work with these children every day. I go into their homes. I sit in their living rooms. I see the anguish. I see the embarrassment of both the children and the parents. These children in foster care are our next generation to be able to support us, to be able to take our society where it needs to go. Many of our children start out really struggling and end up being some of the most successful people you will ever meet.
There's a Gandhi quote that I really love that says, when you're lost, find yourself in the service of others. And I think Jay has been very masterful in doing this by creating Homeless Not Toothless, because what's a better thing to give someone than the confidence of their smile.
We have the responsibility to take care of children. And children that have been pulled out of their families and have no parents to rely on have it hard enough. And the last thing that they need is not to have access to dental care. And we could provide that for them.
Dr. J changed lots of things in my life. And now I have this and a future.
We had made some bad choices and we needed some help. And Dr. J was there for us. We owe him a lot. This is Amariah, and Dr. J really helped her.
My teeth were ugly. Dr. J told me how to clean them. Now I'm cool. I got my smile back.
Thank you, Dr. J.
Thank you, Dr. J.